Dear students, let's now analyze an illustration on electric line which was originated from one charge to another. Here it is saying, two charges Q1 and minus Q2 are placed at points A and B as shown, and a line of force emerges out from Q1 at an angle alpha with line AB, and we are required to find the angle beta at which it terminates on minus Q2. We know well that if these two charges are of equal magnitudes, the configuration of lines from one charge to another will be symmetrical, and both the angles would have been equal. But here, as Q1 and Q2 are not of same magnitude, we'll analyze the situation again. And here we can say, from a charge Q1, all electric lines are originating in radially outward direction like this. And at some distance, a charge minus Q2 is there. So, all the lines which are originated within a cone of a given solid angle will terminate on the charge Q2 within another cone of some solid angle, like if we consider this cone in which all the lines are originating with the half angle of this cone as alpha, and all these lines will terminate within another cone which is having half angle beta, making at point charge Q2, because one line of force which is originated at an angle alpha, if it is terminating on angle beta at minus Q2, all the lines below this line will be also terminating on minus Q2, because no electric line can cut each other. Now, in this situation, what we can do is total flux which is originated from Q1 is Q1 by epsilon naught, and total flux which terminates on Q2 will be Q2 by epsilon naught, that we already know. So, we can find out how much flux will be coming out through this half angle alpha. So, this total flux is spreaded uniformly in a solid angle 4 pi. So, here we can write total flux within the cone of half angle alpha is, this we can write as phi 1, and the value will be Q1 by epsilon naught by 4 pi multiplied by the solid angle subtended at the vertex of this cone. So, that is 2 pi 1 minus cos alpha. Similarly, the flux which is terminating on Q2 can be given as total flux within half angle beta at minus Q2 is, this phi 2 we can write as Q2 by epsilon naught by 4 pi into 2 pi 1 minus cos beta. And here, as all the flux within this cone is equal to the flux within this cone, here we can write phi 1 is equals to phi 2, which gives us, if we equate the two relations, this is Q1 by epsilon naught upon 4 pi and multiplied by 2 pi 1 minus cos alpha is equals to Q2 by epsilon naught upon 4 pi into 2 pi 1 minus cos beta. Here you can see these all values gets cancelled out, and what we are having here will be, on rearranging terms, you can find out the value of cos beta, which is equals to 1 minus Q1 by Q2 1 minus cos alpha. So, this implies the value of beta we are getting here is cos inverse of 1 minus Q1 by Q2 1 minus cos alpha. So, this will be the answer to our problem. We have calculated the value of this angle at which this line is terminating by using the solid angle concept.